Hi, and welcome to Christ Talk. I'm so excited to have author Bridget Holder here today. She's going to tell you about her new book, Sunflower Field. And yes, welcome her into the studio today, Bridget Holder. Hi.
Hi.
Yes.
How are you doing?
Doing wonderful. I'm so glad to have you here today. Author Bridget Holder, you have a new book, and Christ Studios is so excited to bring it to light, to let everyone know that this author is saying hello world, and it's called Sunflower Field. Tell us about your book.
Yes, ma'am. Sunflower Field, it's a book about faith. There's a main character, Abby, and Abby is wanting to grow a field mm-hmm. of sunflowers. And so what happens is she asks her parents, and her parents, they support her by letting her do it, but they don't do the work for her. And so she has to go out. They help her. They go out and they give her the land, but she has to do the work. Okay. And so that's the message I want to get across to children, that, you know, you have a dream. We all dream, and that is good. And so, but you have to put in the work. Mm-hmm. And so she learns by putting in the work. And not only does she do the work, but after she finishes, she has to learn to wait on God to give her what she's wanting.
Beautiful.
So, yes. And so that is the story behind Sunflower Field.
Sunflower Field. Now, for everyone out there, this is a children's book. Can you tell us the ages for the children's book?
The target age is maybe four to seven, but it's really a book that anyone of any age can enjoy and relate to, because it's a book about motivation mm-hmm. and about hope.
Yes.
And the thought of never, you know, giving up on your dream or your goal.
And that's so inspirational. Now, that is right now in a time, and it's hitting a lot of people right now, as far as you're being able to reach a lot of families, a lot of kids who have been doing virtual school, and it has been a change for them. So this book, I think, is right now at a great time where it's giving hope and inspiration. And can you tell us about why that's so powerful now, as far as giving a child hope when they're going through so many different changes?
Exactly. Exactly. The book is actually a testament of my life, of what, you know, things that I've had to go through. And so over the years. And so those things never change. And as children, because I have worked in education for a while, you see kids go through things. And especially, you know, they've been in school all that time, and then they just, you know, had to stop. They're not with their friends, and, you know, they're home all the time. You know, parents are frustrated. They are frustrated. And so it was really just a hard time for everyone. And kids need to have that place of being able to express themselves yeah. in a normal way. And they need to know that it's okay. And so mm-hmm. faith, during this time, we all need it. We
yes.
all need it. And we don't need to forget about our children. And we need to teach them, even through the hard times, hold on. You know, mm-hmm. hold on. Get in the Word of God. You know, give them a couple yeah. scriptures, easy ones that they can remember and take with them. When we're facing adversity, so they'll be able to make it through.
And I think that is so inspirational, and it's inspiring. I know that, as far as you talked about your background in education, can you tell us, was that your inspiration to write the book? Were you a writer in the beginning?
No, but I have always wanted to write. And a children's book has been my passion because of the colors. You know, they're so bright and,
yes.
and vibrant, and the kids, they really grab hold to it, you know? And mm-hmm. so I've worked both in the elementary and at the high school level, and just to see those little kids mm-hmm. Pick up a book and flip through it, and it's heartbreaking. I love it.
Awesome. And that's I believe that is the sweetness, and that is the inspiration for a lot of us as family and parents that have kids. We see that we have to nurture that. We have to nurture the little kid that's in there that wants to read, that wants to learn, that wants to explore. This book, Sunflower Field, I believe, can you tell us what do you believe too? I just believe it's going to give kids hope. It's going to give them a way to express themselves and explore and to imagine. What do you think it will help a child as far as you know, in their imagination. Why do you think that's powerful?
Yes. And so if you look through the book, because I struggled a couple years actually writing it, it started out as a long story. It was a very long story. And then as I thought about it and looking at other books, and I said, it doesn't have to be a long story. You know, it can be short and to the point. And then in discussion, so many questions and so many things can be brought up just from that short story. You know, the limited amount of words, the conversation can be awesome. The conversation can be awesome.
And that's beautiful. I think that we, as far as expressing not only how kids can imagine, it brings hope. Sunflower Field also, you're stating too, you can use a journal with it. You can have question and answer. Teachers can use it in their classroom as a good reading material. What are the things that you would want them to write down? Can you let us know some of the questions and maybe some things to get them started with a journal when writing?
First, they want to write down what their goal is. You know, what is it? Are you wanting to make straight A's for the year? Are you wanting to make the soccer team? Are you, you know, what is your goal for yourself? You know, what is it that you're wanting? And then, you know, how can you, what are your steps? What do you need to do to make that happen? Do you need to study more? Do you need to stay home more? You know, do you want to be a better person? Are you always upset? Are you always sad? You know, what are some steps that you can do to make your goal happen? And you can start off small. They can start off small, take baby steps. And then, you know, it's not going to happen overnight. You know, they may wake up and be like, oh, I tried this, I tried that, and it didn't work. Abby learns in the book, you put in the work, but you have to wait. You have to learn to wait. You know, it takes time.
Yeah, that's powerful. I mean, my kids need to learn to wait.
It's hard. As adults, we can't do it. But, you know, you stay in the word, you learn, and it'll come. It will come. It takes time.
And we need books like this because the Sunflower Field, you're saying it's teaching, inspiring them. It's helping them to explore. It's opening up their imagination, but it's also instilling some good characteristics there of being patient and waiting on it and working hard.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So also for YMCAs, for schools, for different institutions that may want to have this book, how can they connect with you? How can they order the book?
They can order the book through Amazon. It is available through Amazon online, Barnes and Noble, and Walmart.com. Also, you can buy it directly from the publisher, which is Ex Libris. Oh, that's hard to say, .com. But the easiest way, the best way is I always tell people just go online, go to Amazon, Barnes and Noble, or Walmart. And I have some good news because I was looking at on Amazon today and the original price was set at $21.99, which was a bit pricey. And so I looked today and it's down to $12 and I think 15 cents. And so I'm hoping that price will stay down. So if not, it would definitely shouldn't go up more than $12.99. So I'm very excited about that. So it's very affordable now.
And so we also have to reiterate that again, the author is B.H. Holder, which is Miss Bridget Holder, and also the illustrator, Alexandria Seals, right?
Yes. Okay. Yes. 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 She has done a beautiful, beautiful job. A great artist. She's in the South Carolina area. She does wonderful work. She's also on Facebook and Instagram.
Beautiful. Beautiful work. Awesome. So for fundraisers too, you can also check out BH Holder. We want to tell you about her fundraiser that's going on, and she's going to share that information in a little bit. But while she's getting that, I want to let everyone know, in order to connect with BH Holder, you can connect with her and also like her Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. Join her in her conversations also about the book and also express your ideas too and things and thoughts from reading the book. Get the book today, Amazon and also Barnes and Noble. And right now, we're going to also ask her too a little bit before she go. We want to ask her too about her thoughts on inspiring kids and about this fundraiser. So yes, go back to author B.H. Holder.
Yes. My mind has just been twirling with so many ideas about the book. And so I've partnered with Custom Ink for a t-shirt fundraiser. And as I said before, the book is about faith. It's about hope and motivation. And so the t-shirt is My Faith is Strong, because that's, you know, that's what my faith has been over these years. And so, and that's what I want kids to learn, to, you know, to have hope and to have faith and to believe. And so the t-shirt comes in sizes for women and men. And we, you know, the book is for children, so you can get a t-shirt as well. And so, yes, I thank you so much for your support on that.
Thank you. Thank you. And again, remember, you can also check out, she will have a link down so that you will be able to access her fundraiser. And remember to check her out, like her on Instagram, Twitter, and on Facebook. All right. We will share this on YouTube, so that way you can also share this information and also purchase her book, Sunflower Feel, on Amazon.
Thank you so much, Cry Studios.
Thank you. Thank you. Author, B.A. Toter.
Bye.